About 3 years ago, I was in Barbados and I visited high school. And I was just sitting under the trees where we used to have our lunch every day. And all of a sudden, I had this vision of getting everybody back together. So I called a couple of my friends and started getting addresses. And it very rapidly took fire. And it wasn't too, you know, too difficult finding people after that.
History was created in the last week of December 1987. About 400 old scholars of the Lodge School and Codrington High School, students during the 1950s were reunited in Barbados for a week of activities that would revitalize bonds of friendship for years to come.
Thank you. suggest that you ask these questions as you move out into the reunion program and then back to your life and work. Lord, is there anything you particularly want me to say when I go back? Lord, is there anything you particularly want me to do when I go back? Lord, is there anything you particularly want me to be when I go back? And after listening to the answers, add this fourth and further question. Lord, is there anything else you are particularly trying to say to me? He will end by giving you his peace and his blessing, and you must go back out of the center, out to the circumference of the dance, to give your heart, your head, and your hands to the business of the dance of the world and of today. Amen.
After a religious service at Society Chapel, the more adventurous set out on a walk to Bath via Codrington College and along the rugged Consett Bay coastline.
We've got two coming in from Australia, two from New Zealand. I think they're furthest away. And we've got some from Saudi Arabia, Mexico, Austria, all over Europe. We appointed a representative in each country. And they then started feeding the information into us. And people started writing each other, and it was like a chain letter. A lot of the girls and boys I haven't seen for 30, 35 years. And some of the girls and boys left before the, you know, in the mid-50s, and they haven't seen each other. They didn't actually take their old levels or here, but, you know, they were part of the group. The whole concept of the reunion is to bring us all back together, and I can see tremendous benefits coming out of it.
Now we have to have a look at it.
You guys used to swim in the all together in there too?
Now that we've spent so much time relocating the alumni, we can strengthen our old girls and old boys associations. And that's very important. The schools need some good publicity for one thing at this point, and I think with the publicity we're getting in the paper, that's going to change a lot of the thinking.
Ken Hadley is ugly and lazy.
picnic at Bath, many stories of old school days were told.
School days were good days, you know.
I thoroughly enjoyed the whole thing. I would do it all over again.
But this is lovely, seeing them all again.
I have a very vivid recollection of being put in the dustbin in the sixth form and given a beating with a cadet belt.
Be careful what you say.
Large boys.
I was one of four daughters, four sisters, and my, you know, there was no guys in our home, and we just loved the lodge boys, and every week I just looked forward to the next party, or the next fete, the next dance. It was wonderful.
We can't forget the girls, but what we remember most is getting back into the lodge without getting caught. Huh? Those were the happy days when we got away with it all.
The midnight picnics on the hockey field,
ringing the bell and all that kind of stuff.
Climbing over the wall.
Nice to be back in Barbados.
My years here, really, were the most significant that I've had in my life. They really were.
Very special.
Them very, very special. And more so because I'd be coming back almost every year. And for me, coming back to Barbados and seeing all my old friends and school companions, both girls and boys, to me is like charging up my batteries again.
Years ago, when the lodge boys bombed high school with some bandits, with Roger Manning and myself and a few other fellas, when we decided to go over to high school one evening, it was Guy Fawkes night. In those days in Barbados, they used to celebrate Guy Fawkes, you know, not like independence these days. And we went over to high school with some these bandits, they strike them. You remember, Felix, we used to strike them on a matchbox. And all of us had some bushes that we had cut down. So we were crossing the tennis court at high school with these bushes, and every time the mistresses looked through the window, we would just stop, and we had these bushes. And so it looked as if the whole tennis court was just full of bushes.
I'll tell you, I just remember going down to Bath, to Codrington College and swimming in their swimming pool. But it had frogs and the side was mossy. And then when I went there today, there's no pool. It's all been, it's a ruin, you know.
I love cadets. This was my big thing in school days. I mean, I played all kinds of sports, swam, lawn tennis, cricket, football. Not to any great level, but I think cadets was the main thing for me.
Well, I was just talking to one old boy who just had his 49th flogging.
That must have been
Ken Hadley.
I made him get Ken Hadley get that flogging. All the condoms in detention, and Ken Hadley said, well, I'm going to go in detention, not going. So he got the flogging instead, and I made him get it.
Richard. That's terrible.
When he came out of the headmaster's study, he bumped into me, you see. So I said, Hadley, is that the 49th? Go back in and make history and get the 50th.
The day I left, thank God.
Today, no holiday in Barbados is complete without a Jolly Roger cruise. And so, the group set sail for an evening of fun and frolic.
Hello, darling. Do you like fish or steak?
You ain't done yet. I thought he would have been dead long ago. Yeah, man. Yeah, man.
Thank you.
sports day was thoroughly enjoyed by all. Many of those who shone on the field 35 years ago shone again.
The girls and boys I haven't seen for 30, 35 years. And some of the girls and boys left before the, you know, in the mid-50s, and they haven't seen each other. They didn't actually take their old levels or here, but, you know, they were part of the group.
It was just good times.
Remember the midnight feast we used to go on?
A walk.
What was it like? Sneaking around, meeting boys.
They're very inexperienced.
Your team is on that ball team.
Oh, Peggy, I suggest you fall down, because that's all you did.
Just collapse, Peggy. We just wanted a shot of all of us together once again, because just one of us lives in Barbados. This one, everybody else is.
No, I'm a foreigner from the UK.
Say your name.
And I'm Wendy Messiah Redwood Duck from Burlington, Ontario.
Mary Reed Brigadang from Canada.
Elizabeth Simpson from Barbados.
Patty Mall, Miami.
Oh, it's so
Peggy awesome. Bailey, Australia, Perth, Australia.
Audrey Curtin, Surrey, England.
Oh, you all come over here, guys. This was the most handsome boy.
It was, absolutely. No.
We used to fight over him. My sister, you know, would get angry if I'd even have a dance with him. Anyhow.
Don't believe everything she says,
right? What's your most vivid memory of your school days?
My most vivid memory is probably Mr. Walcott giving me a little caning.
for stealing some cane out of the cane field. That's about it.
Come here. No. Des is now a physician in Canada.
Yes.
Portland, Oregon.
USA.
Six children.
He's a smooth
honorary
worker.
Consul of Barbados, state of Oregon.
I'd like to put that in too.
Patty, would you like to introduce David?
Why don't you introduce David?
No, you do it.
This is David Dougal, superior athlete, winner of many
trophies
at Lodge School. Well, how much did you do 100 in, Dave?
Oh,
10.1 or something?
Yeah, that was about
10.1. So he could run fast.
That's 33 years ago. I don't think I can do it again.
This is Tony Colicchio.
Hey there, how are you?
Say hi, Tony.
Sometimes sportsman, sometimes sport commentator.
Very recent refugee.
Recent alumni from the school. 1950 to 1958, in fact.
Sunplant. Sometimes surgeon.
No, he's world-famous surgeon.
Not quite. Surgeon.
We were in the History 6 together.
We were together in the sixth form with Fab Hoyas. Yeah. Long before COVID was even thought of in Barbados.
Right, yeah.
That was only because they trusted you both so intimately.
Let me say that long before the officials thought of COVID in Barbados, because we had COVID at Lodgeon High School from way back in the 20s and 30s, if my father is to be believed. I understand that there was co-ed there, even if not education, co-ed and other things.
We would just like to tell you all.
Famous David Allen.
Bat friend, sometime cricketer, sometime wicket keeper.
Cricket fame.
What a nice guy anyway.
Well, thank you very much. I think what is great is to see all the girls looking so fit and well.
Oh, gosh.
That's the important
gosh.
Thing.
The most significant statement to make, though, is that this thing would not have been possible unless Patty and Brian Burns worked their butts off to do this. And all of us owe them a vote of thanks. And if that's not included in the video, we'll kill somebody.
Yeah, I subscribe to that.
Yeah. Give her a hug, I do more than that, boy. Give her a squeeze.
Wow. Too bad. I thought you knew. Yeah, I don't know.
You'll go under the hurdles. Under the hurdles. After that, you'll go over the benches. You'll go over the benches. How you get over is your business.
This is to find out whether we know the difference
between under and over. When you reach the tennis ball and the PVC pipe, you have to balance the tennis ball on the end of the PVC pipe until you get to this little red marker here in the middle of the tug-of-war rope. When you finish that, drop the ball, go to the spare tire, you will see some string. The string has to be threaded through the PVC tape. Tie it on to the pavilion rail. When you've done that, tie it on to the pavilion rail. I will keep on telling you what to do. Don't worry. Common sense.
And then what?
See, Lawrence Williams, he got a sweet biscuit for you. When you finish that, come here to these buckets of water. Fill up one of the bottles with the glass on top of it. When you finish that, come through the tires, through the grate, and that's the end of it. Through the tires like this.
I know about that.
Right, all the bottles are empty. The glasses are empty. The bucket of water is filled up with water. So dip the glass in the water, fill up the bottle. When the bottle is full, then you come through the tire. Sally?
days.
Ed, did we win?
No, we were
younger. Oh, we came first. Take the train! Burn!
Okay,
give me a letter up to the north.
We won't wait up here. Come on, Brown. We won't wait. Come on, Bobby.
Take the string!
There's 1,000 people up there. Hardly any down here.
Sunset over the cane fields. Another fond memory of school days in the Barbadian countryside. Losers celebrated a marvelous day at a barbecue held at Codrington High School afterwards.
Were you smiling?
There was laughter, laughter, and laughter. A good day and a good evening. Atlantis Hotel was a setting for a traditional Bajan lunch.
The best meal I eat in Barbados,
it's
just like the last school.
The best we've ever had, the whole Caribbean, the best South.
Hey, this is no old girlfriend here, this is my 35-year-old wife. I believe it's the South got me so good.
Her own first famous doctor that takes care of all the girls. This is my son. He's growing up very rapidly.
I have a son.
Very rapidly. These are the people signing up for the next reunion in 5 years' time. As you can see, Sandy has collected quite a list.
And we're working hard at it.
It was evident that Bathsheba still held memories for many. The curtain came down on the week of celebrations at Sunset Crest Beach Club, where the final party was held.
I really didn't believe this was going to come off. The thousands of letters that I'd sent out, the literally hundreds of stamps that I personally stuck on envelopes, and no one would reply. You felt you'd wring someone's neck, everybody's neck, shoot somebody. But come December, there were more and more people registering, and it appeared as though it was going to be a success. But the success has not come from me, as Patty has said, or her. While it was her idea, the success has come from all the people that have worked so tirelessly to make it happen. The city Streetleys, the Arthur Streetleys, Crutch Vidmer, who was responsible for producing all the badges that you have on. We could go on endlessly, but it was a combined effort, and Patty is not solely responsible for the success of the reunion, and neither am I. And I'd like to make that absolutely clear. Therefore, I would like to thank all of those people who worked with both of us to make this thing a success. One last comment. At lunch at Bashba, I saw people signing up for a reunion in 5 years. I have only one comment, because having worked on a list and tried to find people, it was horrible to discover just how many of us had already died. And I think that perhaps a sad note, if you're going to have a reunion in 5 years, let us say, God willing, because we all falling off the perch very quickly these days. Anyway, I've said enough. Thanks very much.
The ex-high school girls have asked if Miss Carter would come up and say a few words. Miss Carter, I hope you will, but as an old lodge boy, I would like, please,
thank you very much,
if you could protect the former students and not mention any of their names. Miss Carter.
I would just like to say very sincerely how much Miss Bourne, Miss Armstrong, and I have appreciated the way you have welcomed us, and I'm sure that every event has got memories for all of you, and I shall certainly go back with very, very happy memories of this week. But I hope the memories will also crystallize, as it were, into an endeavor to encourage the present board of the school as they go forward with new plans. And for some of us, that may mean making a response to an appeal. It may be just writing letters or encouraging people to know about the school. And similarly, those of you from the Lodge School, I know that there are other plans afoot for that. So the fruits of the reunion, I hope, will really be real ones, as well as the great fellowship and friendship we've all enjoyed this week. And I'm sure you're now all dying to get back on the dance floor. Thank you all very much.
Voices were raised in a promise never to forget old acquaintances.
Never brought to mind, should old acquaintance be forgotten.
Woo!